We can sit now. First of all, my name is Ona Wangoi. I am born again. Yesu ni Bwana. I am in Form 1, naenda Form 2. I am in Loreto High School, Limuru. And I am very privileged to be before you. It's so awesome, not preaching to Gibeonites, but to the men and women of God, to sons of the kingdom. And I am very happy because of two reasons. One, because I'm here and I can talk to you. Second, because I'm on the pulpit with my shoes. It feels so nice. It feels so nice. So today our topic is going to be, the topic is planted, not buried. Planted, not buried. And so, as a teenager, and as a pastor, as the kids call me, I have been talking to some of them, and I've also been thinking about my life, and I don't know which of this I am. Am I buried? And you see, when we are in this situation, we are not buried, we are just under. You're not buried. We feel like you're 6 feet under, but you're just under something, and you're going to come out of it so soon. And when you're in this service, I just want to encourage someone's faith, because you know, there is a place that your faith can take you, and you will rise, sustain, and make through. You see, as Christians, most of us, we're in a situation like, God save me. But God says, I want you to make through this situation. I'm not going to save you. You're going to make through it. And God sustains us. But what we want to do is, we want to do what we usually do and expect what God has in line for us to come to pass. You want to go raving, you want to go for road trips, you want to still watch your movies, and you expect what God has in line for you to come to pass. My friend, it will not work like that. And it doesn't work like that. And if you look at the book of Exodus, chapter 13, verse 17, by the way, today I'm only going to do one verse. I'm not piling up a lot of verse, just one verse. Exodus 13, verse 17. And it says, then it came to pass when Pharaoh had let the people go, that God did not lead them by way of the land of the Philistines, although that was near. For God said, lest perhaps the people change their minds when they see war and return to Egypt. So, you see, God has put you in that situation. That situation, you don't know what's going on. You don't know what's going to happen next. Because there's always a shortcut for everything, by the adding Jake on a shortcut. So that's true. But then God has kept you in that situation because He knows, ukifika mali unataka kufika, and then you are faced with a challenge, you'll want to go back to where you are from. You'll want to go back to captivity, like the Israelites. But God is putting you in that situation because He knows that if people say, ukimpanya kae ngumu, because God knows that if you're faced with this challenge over and over, and you will know how to handle it, you will not go back to captivity once you reach your destination. And you just need to understand, during ICC, like, everyone was talking about the wilderness. And Bishop Kamere said that the wilderness is not a place of death, it is a place of empowerment. You are there because God is building you, because God wants you to be that strong person. He wants you to be the person He created you to be. So you don't have to feel like God has abandoned me. No, that's not what's going on. God has kept you there because He wants you to be strong. He wants you to be that great person that He created you to be. And Pastor Jake Laffey said that if you look at the New Testament, it's only once that He talks about enjoying. everything else, enduring. And we are sons of the kingdom. Sindio, we are all sons. And the kingdom is not for those who have enjoyed the world. The kingdom is for those who have endured. The kingdom is for those who have persevered. The kingdom is for those who have tolerated the pain, the strain. So you don't have to enjoy anything, just endure. And this goes to our first point for those who are writing. Under does not mean over. You see, most of us, when you are in a situation, you don't have something, you feel like, I can't do this, you just say, we should give up because it's not going to happen, the vision is not there. What are you talking about? This is God we're talking about, and you're God's child. The vision is there for you, and it's going to happen for you because you are a son in the kingdom. So my verse that I wanted to look at it like extremely is Psalms 1 verse 3. Psalms chapter 1 verse 3. Yes. And it says, he's like a tree planted by streams of water. Okay, to some about water. Like a tree planted by streams. So today we are going to study this verse, like studying it. It's not the way we do it in a devotion, but like soma kabisa. So let's read the first part. He's like a tree. Of all things, a tree planted. Of all things, David compares our relationship with God after maturity to a tree. So right now, I want us to imagine. I want you to imagine yourself as a tree. Not literally. Okay, imagine yourself, you have everything that you need. Imagine you're under no pressure, under no attack. You're just that one person. You're just okay. Moshi, you can imagine yourself with abs, you know. Just imagine yourself like the perfect person, the person you've always wanted to be. You're a student, just imagine yourself with that grade that you've never seen coming. You're a business person, you've never imagined yourself with that booming business. Just that's what God sees. That's you actually. That's who you are created to be. And you don't, but they don't get that image out of your head. Let's continue. Planted by streams of water. Now, do we know why David uses this metaphor? Streams of water, because he's the tree, he's the water, it's planted closely to the water. So it doesn't matter whether it rains or not, it doesn't matter whether it rains or not. This is you planted next to God. It doesn't matter what's going on in the atmosphere. It doesn't matter what you're lacking, because God is your financial supplier. God is your supplier of everything. You need nothing else because you're planted next to God. You need anything, you can just take. It doesn't matter whether your job is failing. It doesn't matter whether you lose a loved one, because you are planted next to God. And if you see, yes, tumemalizana hapo. Sorry, I'm really nervous. I'm very sorry. And let's continue. Which yields its fruit season. So it's a common thing. No tree, akuna tree huwa inapata, it bears fruit every season. Inafikanga a place that tree stops bearing fruit. Sindio? That's true. But then you are the tree planted next to God. It doesn't matter what happens. You are still going to bear fruit. It doesn't matter what happens, you are still going to bear fruit. You get laid off your job, you're still going to bear fruit. You lose a loved one, you're still going to get that fruit. You don't get school fees, you're still going to bear that fruit. It doesn't matter what you throw at me, I'm going to bear fruit. And you don't have to worry about anything, because so long as you're planted next to God, you're still going to bear fruit. So delay. And whose leaves does not wither. This is crazy and weird, because according to study, trees, the leaves must wither and fall off so that the tree can get nutrients that it that will help and enable the tree to go through the cold season, and it stops providing nutrients to the external things so that it can survive the cold season, so the leaves fall off and wither. You are planted next to God. You don't have to hold anything back. You don't have to save anything. Some of you have been saving a lot of things from God. Holding things back, they're not going to help you. God says, as long as you planted next to me, your best idea has not come to you yet. Is how you're going to make this church into a stadium, it has not come to you yet, because you're planted next to God and you don't have to hold anything back, because he's your everlasting supplier. The last part, whatever he does prospers. This is the craziest part, because just imagine anything you think about doing, it prospers. Like anything, mwashi your movie night ingekua because of God. Anything you think about, as in, it will prosper because you're planted next to God. But now the problem is, most of us are potted plants. Even though potted plants, it's not a care baby, and we are not planted in a place that we can grow the roots. We are confined in small spaces. You get the logic? Like, I only went to this school, my family only did this, I'm from this background. God is here to break all your limits. And God is telling us that, don't be potted plants, please, don't be potted. He wants you to be planted in a place when where he can allow you to grow the roots, to withstand the great things that he's building in you. And you don't have to be scared. Like Pastor Emily Kamera was telling us, that there is the carrot type of people. Ukichemka kidogo, you're so soft, you can't do anything. Please, let's not be potted plants. And this gets to our second point. Trees are not planted, seeds are. God has never planted a tree. Have you ever planted a tree, Pastor Dan? You plant a tree, right? Yeah. Trees are not planted. Can you please project for us that? I want us to look at this image. This is how us as believers, we develop. I want us to look at the third diagram. Yeah, the third one. You've seen it. It's very small. Not even the second. It's so small. Kadogo tu. But let me tell you, what you're discounting on because it is so small, my friend, God is counting on it to be tall. Your little gift, your little business, your little, God is counting on that little because he's going to make it tall. He says that I did not give you that big thing because they could destroy it before you knew how to work it. Before you knew how to handle that big business, they would have destroyed it. But God says that small, that little, I'm giving you so that it can be so, so big and tall. So let's look at that diagram. That seed, whenever the seed wants to go up, God says it must humility. You want to be the CEO, but no. You utakuwa CEO, hatuta ipumua hii dunia. We will never breathe because you are the CEO. God says you must have the roots. What are roots? Character, integrity, humility. You can never go anywhere without this. And God says, if you are planted in a place where I can enable you to grow the roots, you will be so great. You will be so, so great. And God just asks asks us one question. Will you stay in the same place long enough for me to allow you to grow the roots that will be able to support the great things that I'm building in you? Will you be able? Because you see, once you fail in something, it's over. I can't do this anymore. Once your business backfires, I can't do this. Just imagine, just because Bish doesn't know how to turn this place into a stadium, Abomoe, Turudi kwa tent. It's not logical. It's not making sense. And I just want to encourage all of you that just stay in one place, because you're moving from that pastor. Don't understand me. That pastor don't. You are the common denominator. When you're Shida, stick in one place and let God work in you. Let God build the roots. And this is so possible. And if you look at the story of Sarah, God made that promise when she was 70, I think. And she gave birth when she was 90. Just imagine 20 years. 20 years. You're a student, ujapata grades for only 3 weeks, and you're giving up. 20 years. But Sarah says, let me help God. Maybe he forgot about the promise he made. And she goes to Hagar and to Abraham, and she tells Abraham, you have to sleep with this woman. We are going to force the promise of God. And what does she do? She makes an illegitimate seed. You're going to make illegitimate seeds with your life. You're moving from this job to this job to this. That wrong leadership that you're under at work, God says that is the condition that will allow your seed to grow into a forest, not a tree. And you have to stay planted in the same place. Please, don't get out. It's hard. It's lonely. And when you're being planted, it's very lonely. So sad, like you are already God. You can bear me witness. When God calls us to the kingdom, it's a hard time, because you find that your friends start going. I don't know, but this is what happened to me when I got born again. My friends walianza kuenda, things I just felt like things are not going right for me. I don't know. Has that ever happened to you? Yeah. And when you planted, you just ask God a lot of, like, why? Oh, why is this not happening? Why is this not working? I'm church every Sunday, paying my tithe, but I'm still broke. Why is this not? I don't know about you. You pray, it happens. Forget you. I pray, sometimes it never happens. And I just ask God, Why is this not happening? Why am I revising but the grades are not coming up? It's not working out for me. But then, this is a story that God, the place of death and the place of destiny look the same for a season. The place of death and the place of destiny look the same for a season. Just look at that, the second diagram. Just imagine how it feels. It feels like it's never going to be that tree. And you see, let me give an example. I take a seed, dig, plant, and I take a coin. I do the same. All that. What do you think will happen? By the coin, this brings us to what I'm dreaming at. The faith that you have, the trust in God that you have, that's what is going to make you to be that tree. That is what is going to make you to be that tree. Because what is in you, what you believe, what you as in me, what is in you, what you believe in, and that is what is going to make you that person. Should I say what or whom? See, there's a song I like. It says, I'm going to dance and praise him in
doesn't matter what comes my way. The greater one lives inside of me. If the greater one lives inside of you, you are not going to be a tree, you are going to be a forest. What is in you is what's going to motivate that growth. You cannot be empty and you just think that it's going to happen. I usually have a problem with speaking in tongues. It came once and it never came back. So I came to Mwashi. I went to Mwashi and he told me, "Wewe unajua, tongues will come, they must come. But will they come if you're not walking with the Holy Spirit? Will they? Because as far as I'm concerned, it's a gift of the Holy Spirit. This is the same. You're not going to grow unless you have the faith. You are not going to grow. And if you have that faith, you know, when you've been planted, the enemy is the one who's going to come and convince you that God has abandoned you. Just curl up and die. But if you have that faith, oh, you will tell the enemy, "Excuse me, Mr. Man, God has a great plan for me. And I know that there is a vision for me." And yeah, that is what will convince you. Philippians 1:6. Yeah, if you look at Philippians 1:6, it says, "Being confident of this, that he who began a good work, in who? As Christians, we think that God is going to create a good work in Bishop, in Pastor Kibira, in Pastor Beatrice. Excuse me, you are a child of God. He is creating a good work in you. And if you continue, it says that we'll carry it out to completion. Till when? Do I need to explain? Because God had to bangi kionjo. You see the way you're cooking. Oh my God, you must cut it. God does not do that. Kama anakupia, he will give you to completion. He is not going to leave his work because he's run bankrupt of blessings. Please, this is the kingdom you're talking about. Pastor Kibera was telling us that the kingdom can never be bankrupt. Our businesses can be bankrupt, but the kingdom of God can never be bankrupt. And I just want us to have that faith and just know that it's not over. Someone say that it's not over. I'm just under. You see, faith. It's not over. I'm just under. No, you get it. And you just need to stay planted in the place where you can get roots. People will talk, by the way. They must talk. No matter to go and talk. People must talk. And you will feel so intimidated. They will get just, "Oh my God, you're saving yourself? Till marriage?" That is Imrembo sana. Let me tell you. God says, do that. Because what God is preparing for you requires purity. And there's someone on the other side who's doing the same thing. And at the end of it all, equal has to meet equal. And you'll be holy to a marriage. Continue doing what you're doing. They must criticize you. Starting with that small bit. Your little business. Oh my God, okay. Let me tell you, that is a seed. A legitimate seed that God is planting. And trust you, it will grow into the hugest tree. I don't even know how to explain. And you find that once you cannot stay in the same place for God to enable you to grow the roots, you start uprooting yourself. And it is so hard because once you uproot yourself from that situation, you try to get an easy way out. It will be so so hard once you realize it was not worth it. Because you will start from scratch. Just misipendi kuumizwa. I don't like pain. So why should I not stay in the same place and enable God to work in me, remove myself, na nianze square one? Remember, you come struggle to put a marafiki to alko amenda earlier. Let's just stay planted at the same place and let's not be potted plants. That's just what I want to encourage. Don't be a potted plant. Because once you're a potted plant, the funny thing is that a potted plant, that person tries to go everyone to look good and be seen. We all of us try to look good. I did my best. We try to look good, but trust me, once you're planted in God, you will not even realize you look good, because you will look good. You will look, you will be healthy, you will be successful, and utakuwa, like, someone will be complimenting you. Like, example, this is what Moshi does. Aki Moshi elekeza zake, can you notice? That's what happens. You will not even realize. Because once you planted in God, they are automatic. You get it. Maybe to, as in, they're just there. And just remember, when you're in this situation, don't leave God. Because when you suffer with God, you will reign with God. When you suffer with God, you will reign with God. Once you're in that situation and you don't know what to do, but you're still with God, you're seeing you're not letting go. Remember what Job did? God allowed Satan to make Job suffer. You're in that situation not because God is punishing you, not because God wants to take you out, but because God is building you, because God is molding you and enabling you to grow the roots. I'm really emphasizing on the roots, because if there's something that can make a tree fall, it's lack of roots. Roots anchor, support the tree. And once you get the roots that God is giving you, the character, humility, integrity, you will be so great. And remember what Bishop Bulibo said, faith and serving, when you have those two, you're dangerous. You are so dangerous. Because you have that faith, that it doesn't matter what come my way, because the greater one lives inside of me, everything is working together for my own good. And that's what you have to keep in mind. So, and another thing, let's avoid comparing ourselves to others, because God reminds us that as the sons of the kingdom, our intrinsic value is so high. It cannot be compared to gold. Just imagine, kama I see the accounting gauge compared to the rose. What would have happened? See, ata kungekuwa na rose. Because it would have ingetoka. So don't compare yourself to others. There are many churches in this Kenya, but your church is the best. This church is the best. Always tell yourself, I am the best. I am the best. You are the best parent ever. You're the best student ever. You're the best. As long as you are a son in the kingdom, you're so great. There's no one who can be compared to you, because you're so great. And remember, this situation, just something I'd like to tell you. God uses the foolish to confirm the wise, and the weak to confirm the strong. You may be planted, and they may think that you're so weak, you're so naive, they don't know what's in you, that you can be more and do more. But God says that what you see is not what I see. What you see is temporary. I see the permanent thing. And you are so strong. It's just that He wants you to look weak, so that at the end of it all, He can do a miracle. That's who our God is. Miracle worker. He is a miracle worker. You will look weak for a season. Trust me, you're very strong. You are so strong. And the last thing, don't run away from suffering. Don't.
you must suffer either way. You might think that maybe if I do this, I may not suffer as much as I'm suffering. Trust you me, you will suffer. In everything, there is suffering. At the childhood, you're going to suffer. Trust me. There are some who did not know the following day. Like, you can be alone on Wednesday, you're like, gosh, what are you doing? To that person, he's really suffering. Because he does not know the days of the week. In everything, there is suffering. High schoolers, kuna suffering, sindio. Suitcase yako ikiraruliwa, iyo umesuffer. Like, you don't know what to do. And I'm pretty sure in the outside world for older people, there is more suffering. Because the way my mother talks, I don't even want to grow up. Trust you, me. She's like, unaeka hiyo sukari aje? I'm like, God, this is what I'm going to face. You know what, I'm staying. Nakuwa mtoto for the rest of my life. Don't try to run away from suffering. It will be there. No matter where you go. And even if you go to Australia a million times, I know you still suffer. There will be suffering. Don't run away from suffering. As much as you suffer with God, as long as you suffer with God, trust you, you will reign with God. You must reign with God.